Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Spotlight has changed a lot with macOS Tahoe. Here are 10 tips for searching for files with Spotlight. So in macOS Tahoe and beyond, you can use Spotlight for all sorts of things, launching apps, performing actions, looking at your clipboard history. But primarily, you probably still want to use Spotlight to search for files, and you can certainly do that. In fact, you can click on the Spotlight button in the menu bar or Command Space to bring up Spotlight and just search for a file, and you'll probably find the result you want. But there are a bunch of tips that might get you better results quicker. The first is to tell Spotlight that you specifically want to search for files. You could do this a couple different ways. First, you can set Spotlight so it's only searching for files. The way to do that is move your pointer up to Spotlight, and you'll see four buttons appear to the right. The second one is for just files. If you click on that, Spotlight changes into a mode that's only going to search for files. You can do the same thing by using Command Space and then immediately pressing 2 on the keyboard, or Command Space and then Command 2. This takes you to the same place here. You see it says files at the top. You get some suggestions here. You get some recents, and you could scroll through these. And then, of course, you can just type and start searching. But there are two different modes here, depending upon how you like to see your results. This is the grid mode here. You can see all the icons displayed in a grid, but you can click here on the three dots button and show as a list. And when you do that, you'll see everything with one result per line. So all the suggestions here, recents, and all of that. So pick whichever one you like better. Now let's try a search. I'm going to search for the word example. And you're going to see results here that all have example in the name. That may not be the case all the time because it's also looking in the contents of the file. I'll show you later how to only search by name. With all these results here, there's a lot to look through. You can narrow these results down by clicking on one of these categories or apps. So a lot of these are going to be apps, like here's Pages, for instance, here's Keynote. But sometimes there's going to be general file categories, like here's folders, and here's simply PDF. So if I click on PDF here, you could see the results now change to the only PDF files, and then it's still going to use the same text here. So here's some examples of some things that don't actually even have that in the title, but you can bet they're in the content of that file. Notice also, when you get to this point, it does change to list view, even though the initial results were an icon view. Now, if you want to start off right away using one of these categories, you certainly can. Before you type anything, you can click on one of these, like let's click here on numbers, and then you'll see numbers appear there, and then you could type something to search for, and you'll get results like this. But another way to do it without actually clicking is to type a slash, a regular forward slash, and then type either the app name or the file type, like PDF. And then press return. And now you'll see that you're only going to get PDF results. And now you can type more to narrow it down to the contents or file name. The slash can be used for something else as well, something very useful. Previously, when you searched in Spotlight, it gave you results from all over your Mac. If you wanted only results in a specific location, you had to use a search in the Finder. But you can now tell it which folder to search in by using the slash and then typing the folder's name. So I'm going to start typing documents here, and you can see it's going to give me the first option there, documents. I can select that with the keyboard, or I just clicked on it, and it's going to narrow searches now in that folder. So when I type something else like this, I'm only going to get results that are in my documents folder. You can use this for any folder name. So if you know you've got a folder, say called Project Alpha, you can do slash Project Alpha, and it'll find that folder there. As you can see, I've got two of them, so I can use the arrow keys and go down and select which one I want. I'll select this one, and now it's only going to give me results in that folder. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, sometimes you're searching for files, and you can see the little icons here, either in grid or list view, but you're not sure which one you want. So you can use the arrow keys to go down and select one here, and you could see I get the full file name there at the top. But also when you're doing this, when you have that blue outline around one of them, you could press the space bar. And this will bring up Quick Look the same way that Quick Look is brought up in the Finder. And you can then use space bar again to dismiss it, go to another one, use space bar again to bring that one up. As a matter of fact, you can continue to use the arrow keys. I'll move Quick Look over to the side here. And notice that when I use the right arrow keys, it goes to the next item there. And it allows me to move around inside of the results and still keep the Quick Look window up. You can resize the Quick Look window. You can move Spotlight over like that. So if you really wanted to get some serious searching going on, have a nice preview of it here, you can just set things up like this and then continue to use the arrow keys to look around at your results. Now, another thing you may want to do is instead of opening the file, you may want to go to where it's located. So you can use the arrow keys to get to where you want, like this file here. And instead of clicking on it or pressing return, you can use either Command R or Command Return. And instead of opening it, it'll go to a new Finder window and show you that file. Now, let's say you want to do a Spotlight search, but not a new one. You want to do the same one you did three or four back, right? You just want to repeat a search to find maybe a different file. Well, with the new Spotlight, you have a history of your searches. So use Command Space to bring up a Spotlight search. If you want, Command 2 just to focus on files. Now, use the up arrow key, and it shows you the previous search. And you could keep using up arrow to go through all of your previous searches. So, for instance, I can go back to this one looking for PDF files with the word example, and then just press return, and it repeats that search. Now, you may be looking for a way to go directly to the files section in Spotlight. You've got this button here, but then you need to click on files. You've got Command Space, but then you need to do Command 2. Well, wouldn't it be great if there was a way to go directly to it? In System Settings, if you go to Keyboard, and then from there to Keyboard Shortcuts, and then to Spotlight, you only have a way to go directly to Spotlight Search, to go to a Finder window for search, or you could set one up to go right to the first section, which just shows apps. I open the feature Apple Adds Slots for Shortcuts to go to Files, Actions, and Clipboard. But until they do, you could set this up in the Shortcuts app. So I'm going to launch Shortcuts here and create a new shortcut. Let's call this Spotlight Files. And I'm going to set a nice little icon here. I'll keep it gray. I'll search for a magnifying glass. Nice. So I've got that there. Now let's add an action. Now there is an action for Spotlight, open search. And if you run this, it brings up Spotlight search, but it doesn't take you to the files section. This is kind of handy to know about because you can actually pre-populate the search with some text here. But we're not going to use that because we want to go directly to file search. Instead, we're going to search for run JavaScript for Mac automation and add some JavaScript coding here. It's only three lines, and here they are. It just tells application system events to issue key code 49, which is the space bar with the command key down. Then it's going to wait 2/10 of a second, which I found will work to wait for the Spotlight menu to appear. And then it's going to send another keyboard command, 19, which is the number 2 with command down. So when I run this, it goes right to files. So now I could do a few things with this. I could go to file, and then I could add to dock. It'll add it to the dock. Let me bring it out over here next to applications. And now anytime I want, I can click it and it'll go right to files. I could also though go to the details section here on the right side of Spotlight. I can turn off show in Spotlight. Of course, that's not needed, but I can add keyboard shortcut. And let me add something like, let's say Control Option and F for find. And now I can quit shortcuts here and do Control Option and F and bring up a file search in Spotlight. Now, my last tip is that even though you have this great way to search for files using Spotlight, the king of searching for files is still Finder. Just open a new Finder window and then use Command F to start searching. You've got the search field here. You could also use that Option Command F I pointed out earlier to jump right to this. And now you can search for something just like in Spotlight, but you get many more options. Right down here, you can search this Mac or just the folder that you were in when you started the search, so you can narrow it down. You also can set kind is and set it to a different kind, but also change it from kind to create a date, last modified date. Search the name only, search contents only. Go to other and search for tons of attributes for files. A lot of these apply to video and photo metadata, for instance. And you could add multiple criteria here, even holding down the option key and creating little groups of criteria with any, all, or none. So basically and, or not here to really create some complex searches. And then even save the search here, also known as a smart folder. So the Finder still is the most powerful way to search for files. Spotlight is simply the quickest. But here's one more bonus tip, and it's how to make the Spotlight menu search more like the Finder search. You can do that if you know a few little tricks. You can go to a regular Spotlight search and just type name colon and then some text. And now it's only going to give you things that have that in the name. So the results here are only going to have the word example in the name. It's going to ignore the contents. You could also use Boolean operators. So I could search for something like this example here, and then I could use and, or not. So I could say and book, and now the results are going to be narrowed down by that. If I want it just to be the file name, I can do that too. So now I'm only going to get results where the words example and book both appear. The key is to get accurate results, you need to have this in uppercase, A-N-D, all uppercase. And you could do or as well, and you can do not as well too, and you'll get the right results. Oh, and there is one more little new feature in Spotlight Search in macOS Tahoe, and that is that you can now search on other cloud services like Dropbox and Google and Microsoft and all that. If you've set up one of those with your Mac, the Spotlight search should actually reach out and give you results from those services, not just from your Mac and from iCloud. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.